Good morning, students. Yesterday we had completed our first chapter, our first part of the lesson, that is the variation of small g's. Today we'll go a little further. That will include our satellites, its projection, as well as the value of critical velocity, orbital velocity, escape velocity, all these things. And we'll start with the problems also today. So yesterday one point was remaining, the variation of small g with respect to the rotation. Okay, just let us cover what we had covered yesterday. What is the value of small g with respect to a height? It is given by the value of small g on the surface of the earth. Put the value of h, put the value of r, and get whatever the value of acceleration due to gravity at certain height. Okay, like if you go on Mount Everest, put that height, calculate that gh value, and then you multiply it by your mass, and you will get the value of your weight on that point of height, like on Mount Everest. But this is for a very higher height, like for 3000 kilometers, 4000 kilometers. This formula is used to calculate the value of g when satellites are launched. They are launched at very higher heights, right? So in that situations where the height is considerably high, you will use this formula. Okay, that's why we written a higher arrow. What is this is depth. When you go in deep into the tunnels or keep on driving deeper, at that time you will use this formula. Okay, there was one yesterday we had drawn one graph. What was that? It was comparing between these three situations. Yes, so what did we understand there? See, at the higher heights gravitation reduces very quickly because it is -2, na? -2 means it's reducing by 2 times faster, but at depth it doesn't reduce so much, huh? So what is that you learned? At a higher height your weight will become very less quickly, but as you go deep down the earth, your weight will not become less as quickly. As you rise higher, your weight will become lesser quicklier, more quicker. And what is it? Gravity at poles is greater than gravity on the surface. Okay, that is why, because yesterday we talked about it was because of the shape of the earth. Due to rotation, what happens? The radius of the earth has got little lesser, right? That's why. Now what is the last point that we had forgotten yesterday to remember? This is that value. What is that? G at an angle theta. Theta is what? At an angle. See, we have put latitudes and longitudes on earth. You must have seen globe, right? So in a globe, what do you see? There are these lines, horizontal lines called as latitudes. Each of them are marked with certain angle theta, right? So these angle theta are just telling you the angle from the center of the earth. If this was a circle, so if this was circle and you have drawn this angle theta, if earth was its projection, if you take earth is a sphere, if you just take earth as a circle and then project it and see what are the angles. So this angle will be 0 degrees. Let us start counting from here. Okay, if you come at this point on the globe, okay, and then draw a imaginary circle. So on each and every point on that circle will be measuring same angle from the center of the earth, because if you see earth in a projection of two dimensional, that is as a circle, all this line will be coming at the same angle. Yes, this will be theta. At this point also it will be same angle theta. Yes, so each and every point on that imaginary circle will be having same angle theta. So your angle is what? Theta is what? The angle of latitude. Theta is the angle of latitude. Is it clear, students? Theta is the angle of latitude. Okay, now if this value of theta is given, what is the role of this theta as the earth rotates? Students, as the earth rotates very, very fast. So what happens? Because earth rotates, due to centrifugal force, whenever earth rotates, what should happen? The body on the earth should be thrown outside, right? It should be thrown outwards. So, but when it is thrown outwards, its weight is reduced. Why? Because it is moving, it wants to go outside, right? So what happens? Its weight is trying to go away from the center. But what is gravity doing? Gravity is pulling it towards the center. So net value of g again reduces. So that reduced value is given by this formula. Now what is this component here? This component is the value of that centrifugal force acting at that particular point. In detail, if you want this formula, it is there in 11th standard. Like for now, just use this formula. If in exams, put the answer, put the formulas and get the answer. Okay, then okay. This is it. Now we will go for, you just write it down, then we will go further. for the details. This is cos squared theta. Okay, cos theta, all the trigonometric values we have been given the table. Just put the values. Okay, omega is the value of angular rotation of the earth, angular speed. What is omega? Omega is angular speed. You know angular speed? What is angular speed? Okay, in certain unit of certain amount of time, what is the angle covered? In 1 second it covers 2 degrees. Then what is the angular velocity? 2 degrees per second. If in 1 second it covers 5 degrees, then what is the angle of rotation? 5 degrees per second. Likewise, you can calculate the angular velocities. Okay, same angular velocities. What is the angular velocity for rotation of Earth then? Earth rotates one complete circle in how much time? 24 hours, right? One rotation. So 24 hours includes how many seconds? 24 into 60 into 60 seconds. So this is the angular velocity of the Earth. This value we have to put it here and find the answer. Okay, just these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 formulas are important for you in this lesson while solving problems. Okay, let's move on to the next part. Yes, what is that? Mass and weight. What is mass? Energy. What is mass? Mass is nothing but energy in consolidated form. What is mass? Mass is nothing but the energy in consolidated form. We are all masses. How we are formed? We are formed due to energy, right? Constantly eating. But energy consolidates within us. Then that's how mass accumulates. Okay, mass is accumulated. And with gravitational force in the space, in the clouds, in the far, if you go on observing in space, there are far bigger and bigger clouds, like very dust, huge dust. So all this mass keep on accumulating and keep on, due to gravitational force, they form bigger and bigger, heavier and heavier masses. Okay, so that is about mass. What is about weight? Weight is similar thing. Weight is nothing but it is mass that is experiencing force on the a planet. Now for Earth, we'll consider on the Earth, whatever exertion you feel on the Earth, that is force due to gravity, that is called as weight. It is a terminology, as we all know, we have been using this since our childhood. What is the weight of that object? What is the weight of that object? Okay, what is the weight? Weight is nothing but mass into these values of gravity that we are learning at that particular time. Okay, that is mass into acceleration. That is weight is nothing but mg. Okay, clear students? Okay, now we'll move on to the next and very important point, that is critical velocity and escape velocity. What is critical velocity and what is escape velocity and where they are used? Okay, let us see. Critical velocity is the velocity with which a planet is able to rotate, able to revolve around the like, for example, this is Earth, okay, and this is a satellite S. Okay, with what velocity it rotates around the Earth? This velocity is called as VC. VC means critical velocity. VC is critical velocity. So value of VC is what? Critical velocity. Okay, now what happens if critical velocity is less? Okay, if critical velocity is less, the satellite will fall down on Earth. Okay students, so rockets, what do rockets do? Rockets rockets raise the satellite to a certain height, yes, and they just give a forward thrust to it. They give a critical velocity. They impart energy, kinetic energy, such that it acquires critical velocity. When it acquires critical velocity, it is able to rotate with such a sufficient speed that it neither flies off into space nor falls down. It neither falls down nor flies off. With such a sufficient velocity, when it rotates, then that velocity is called as critical velocity. Why it is important? Why have they used that word critical? Because this is critical situation where the satellite shouldn't even escape nor should it fall down on Earth. Okay, that is why it is called as critical velocity. Okay, and what is escape velocity? Escape velocity is that velocity with which any object on the Earth, if you throw, it escapes out into the space. That velocity is called as escape velocity. If I throw this object like this on Earth, okay, it's falling down. If I still throw higher, it again falls down. But if I have to throw it a speed so high that it doesn't come down, that is called as escape velocity. Now, with what velocity I should be throwing it? That is 11.2 kilometers in 1 second. in 1 second, I have to throw this object with 11.2 kilometers. In 1 second, it should acquire 11.2 kilometers, so long distance. Then only then it will not come back to the Earth. Simple? Okay. So these are the values. Now we'll see what are the projection of satellite and how do they do it. Okay. Projection of satellite, we'll just see. Newton did one thought experiment. Okay. First, we'll see what was that thought experiment. He had a cannon. Okay, cannon means he used to throw a fire a cannonball. So what happens? He just thought. It was a thought experiment. So what did he do? He thought that if I throw this, fire this cannonball with certain velocity, so what would happen, students? It would fall after some time. Yes. If we keep on increasing, then what would happen? It will fall after even at longer distance. But if we throw it every time it is thrown, what happens? It acquires a little larger distance, but sufficiently if you give it such a velocity that it keeps on rotating and doesn't fall back. It keeps on rotating. If first situation what it fall down here, next situation it fell down here, but now you are going to give it certain velocity that the cannonball keeps on rotating. Now that velocity would be called as critical velocity of that cannonball on the Earth's surface. Okay, so critical velocity means what? That velocity of the object that would make it revolve. What is critical velocity? That velocity with which, that sufficient velocity. Critical velocity is that sufficient velocity with which an object is able to revolve around a planet at that particular height. Okay, so after this thought experiment was done, he even tried to increase this speed. Okay, that is what happens when we launch the satellites. What happens? If you keep on increasing the speed, what happens? It then follows different trajectories. Okay, that we'll just see in the situation of projection of satellite. Okay, so what is that? We will draw a planet Earth. Okay, and if a satellite is raised here, what would the first situation if there is satellite is raised, a rocket is there, a rocket has been launched into the space. Okay, with this satellite, rocket has come here and suddenly out of fear. So what would happen? The satellite will come down, first case. Then let us take second case. Second case is such that the rocket's second stage has come down successfully and it has, the satellite was given certain velocity, but that velocity wasn't sufficient, students. So what would happen? The satellite would come down at this point, right? Yes, yes. But if you give it a velocity v such that it is not equal to critical velocity but a little lesser than critical velocity, so what will happen in that case? In that case, it would not complete a circle, but it would come down very close to the Earth, but again come back to the same point. Which is this velocity? When the velocity imparted is lesser than critical velocity. Lesser than critical velocity. Okay, now why does this happen? This happens because the velocity of that that satellite is not enough to acquire the kinetic energy that would balance its balance its centrifugal force. Okay, the centrifugal force here, there is a weight acting on that satellite. Yes, there is a weight acting downwards, and at the same time there is centrifugal force MA. Now what is that centrifugal force MA? MA is centrifugal force is given by MV square by R. This is not there for you, but when this is equal at that point, the weight is equals to the centrifugal force. In this situation, what you get is both are completely balanced. Okay, in that situation it will be performing perfect circle. Now what is that perfect situation? We'll draw it. Okay, this is not the perfect situation. Here the velocity is still lesser than critical velocity. It will not complete perfect circle. So when it is performing complete circle, then you will give the satellite a velocity v which is equal to the critical velocity. Now when we are giving a critical velocity, so what should happen? It is rotating in a perfect circle around the earth. So at that time, what happens? It is performing perfect circle, perfect circular motion. Okay. Or you can say exact circular motion, because at each and every point when it rotates on the satellite, on this orbit, what happens? Its downward weight mg, okay, mg is balanced by the outward centrifugal force mv square by r. Okay, that is v, its velocity. What is the value of velocity then? If you just equate mg equals mv square by r, m should get cancelled with m, v square is equals to gr, so v equals to under root gr. So this is the value of critical velocity. What is the value of critical velocity? The value of critical velocity should be how much? It should be equals to under root gr. When it is equals to the value of under root gr, when the value of velocity given to the satellite equals to the value of g at that point, at a height g and at radius r at that point, if you find the value of g at this point, if you find the value of r at this point and put it in this formula, and whatever velocity you get, with that velocity if you move that satellite, then and only then it will perform what? Circular motion. If it happens that the velocity is lesser than the critical velocity, then it will follow such elliptical path. Okay, if it is even lesser, then it will fall down. So what, how much value you should give to that satellite? If you want to launch a satellite, what should you do? You should calculate the value of g at that height. Okay, you want to go at certain height. Okay, calculate the value of g at that height, gh. Calculate the value of r at that point. R means what? R is the total distance between the two objects. That will be equals to r plus the extra height h. Now if you put this value vc equals to under root gh into r plus h, then you will get the critical velocity. And that critical velocity, if you have calculated, and that velocity if you have given to that particular satellite, then and only then it will perform the perfect circular motion, or in the perfect circular orbits. Okay, so what is this? Critical velocity. The satellite will rotate with critical velocity. What is the value of critical velocity? G, small g into r. Okay, we write it into the terms small gh into r. We always write small r. Okay, what is small r? Small r is the distance between the two objects. Capital R is the radius of the earth, and h is the height. Okay students, so you know what is this value of critical velocity? It is equals to under root g into r. Now if you have given it at this point, you have given a more velocity, more than critical velocity, then what will happen at that point? Okay, you just write it down. At that point, what would happen? If you give a velocity which is more than critical velocity, it will perform a ellipse with this point. Point of projection will be lesser. This point of projection is lesser than the, see, this is point of projection. Okay, point of projection, and this is the closer point, and this is the farther point. Do you see this? This is the farther point. Now here, what is the situation? With what is the velocity that you have given to the orbit? Velocity given is greater than critical velocity. So this is the third case. Okay, first case lesser than critical velocity, second case equal to critical velocity, third case greater than critical velocity. In first case, what happened? V is less than critical velocity, path is elliptical. Yes, second case, V equal to VC, path is circular. And third case, V is greater than critical velocity. If you give more velocity to satellite, again the path is elliptical. But just remember, when it is lesser, the point of projection is smaller. Okay, the point of projection itself, okay, the point of projection is this height from where we have to project it. This height will be when the v is lesser than critical velocity, this height will be less. When v equals to vc, this blue diagram, critical velocity, it will be equal at all the points. But when v is greater than critical velocity, at that point what should happen? The point of projection is lesser. Okay, and what happens if you equate it to escape velocity? Last point, v is equals to v escape. When you give a velocity which is equal to v escape velocity, then from that point it moves directly into space. Okay, it doesn't come back. So this is the fourth diagram. What is the fourth diagram? It doesn't return back. Okay, so these, remember these four points. These are the four points that you need to understand whenever they ask in projection. Okay, it escapes out. Parabolic. Okay, escapes out into space parabolically. It doesn't come down. Okay, so these are the points that you understood. What did we understand? Again, finally, that whenever you launch a satellite, you need to give it velocity, and that velocity should be equal to critical velocity when it should perform perfectly circular motion. Okay, if it equals to escape velocity, it will move out. Just wait, we'll see the values of critical velocity and escape velocities. The value of escape velocity on the surface of the earth is 11.2 kilometers per second on the surface of earth. On the surface of earth. Okay, and if you need to find out, the value of VE is equals to under root 2GR. What is the value of VC? VC, just now we had found out. What is the value of VC that we have found out here? VC equals to under root GR. Okay, so today's first formula is this one. Today's first formula that we are learning is VC, that is critical velocity, equals to G into R. What is today's second formula? V escape velocity. Just learn it today. Directly just multiply it. Okay, do not. Now here we have put the value capital R, which means it is on the surface of the earth. Okay, it is on the surface of the earth. On the surface of the earth, value of escape velocity is 11.2 kilometers per second. What is the value of critical velocity? It is different because the value of R is different. But if you ask on the surface of the earth, on the surface of the earth means at this surface of the earth, if I want to keep this marker, with what speed I should throw this marker such that it moves but again keeps on performing circles around this surface of the earth. So if you want to find that velocity with which this marker, I want to make this marker a satellite, what should I do? I should give, if this marker has to be a satellite, then I should throw this marker with such a speed that it performs circles around the earth. Now it is here, it should go and perform entire rotation or revolution around the earth and then again come back from here. That means at that point it is having critical velocity. Then what is that value of critical velocity? Use again this same formula. G of the earth, you know, 9.8. What is R? R is equals to R plus H. But on the surface of the earth, H is 0. So if you put the value of VC, then it comes out to be how much? The value of, it comes out to be 7.92 kilometers per second. 7.92 kilometers per second. These values you learn it. Okay, students. With how much values you should throw this marker on the earth? 7.92. So that it should again come back. But if you make it equal to 11.2, it will not come back. Okay, students. So got it? In short, very good. Okay, so this was, if it happens that all it is going a little faster, little too much, don't worry, we have to just go for the final values. Nobody is going to ask you how it has come. Remember the final values. What is it? As much as you understand it, send your doubts. Okay, good. And next point we will start is the weightlessness of a satellite. So in set, when you jump down a, whenever you are going in a, for example, you are in a lift. So in a lift, what happens? At some point of time, when you are rising above the lift, what happens? You experience more weight. Okay, but when the lift comes down, free fall lift is there, you don't experience weight, right? When you are in a giant wheel and the giant wheel comes down, do you experience weight? No. When you are jumping off, do you experience your own weight? No, at that point you do not experience your own weight. Why am I able to experience my own weight now, students? Because the surface is exerting equal and opposite reaction to me. That is why I am able to experience weight. Right, students? So, we are talking about weightlessness situation. Right? Similar weightlessness situation happens in a satellite also. In satellite, people do not feel their own weight. Why? Their surface is there, na? Ground surface is there, then they should feel their weight. But what happens, students, in a satellite, whenever we are talking about the Earth and there is certain satellite that is keep on rotating around the Earth. So if a person is there here inside the satellite, what happens to that person? That person is not only resting on this surface, but he is performing revolutions around the Earth. And because we learned just now that this person is rotating around, revolving around the Earth, which velocity? Critical velocity. That is equals to under root gr at that point. Yes, but at that point what happens? He is experiencing a downward weight mg, but it is balanced by the upward velocity mvc squared by r. Okay, this component vc squared by r is called as centrifugal acceleration. This is there in circular motion, this formula in your 11th standard, centrifugal acceleration, v square by r, this centrifugal acceleration. Now how this formula has come, it is little process is there, there is derivation. Acceleration is equals to v into omega is there. Okay, whenever you need to accelerate, you need to rotate something in a circular motion, what do you need to do? You need to give it velocity as well as you need to give it impart angular velocity. So v into omega, that is the angular acceleration. And what is that? If you know, need to know what is angular velocity, then it is nothing but a velocity of that object per unit is radius. So it comes out v square by r. Okay, this point is there in 11th standard, so you know, no need to learn it, just remember that centrifugal acceleration is equals to v square by r. Okay, so this both the values, okay, are equal and opposite. These both the values are equal and opposite, and that is why what happens at certain height, weight is equals to zero. Because what is weight? Weight is equals to your weight that you experience on the Earth. What is that? Huh? It is equal and opposite. Now, each and every time you experiencing a downward weight mg, it is balanced by the centrifugal force mv square by mvc square by r. So these both are equal and opposite. Mg equals mvc square by r. These are both are balanced. Okay, so it comes out to be, weight is coming out to be zero, because every time the satellite is rotating, even the satellite itself is falling on the Earth. Like we have known, why moon is not falling on the Earth? Moon is falling on the Earth actually each and every time moon is falling on the Earth. But what happens? Moon cannot come down to Earth. Moon falls on the Earth, but moon cannot come down to Earth because it is balanced by the centrifugal force. So in same situation, satellite is also falling on the Earth each and every time. Like you have a chair and you fall down with the chair on Earth, what will happen? Will you experience weight? No. You have a chair and you jump down with chair, you don't experience weight. Similarly, in a satellite, you don't experience weight. Why? Because actually even the satellite is falling down, but due to the centrifugal force, what happens? Due to the centrifugal force, what happens? It doesn't come down. Okay, centrifugal force. Yes, so this is equal to the centrifugal force. It is also equal to the centripetal force that you will learn details later on. Just remember that both are equal. Both are equal. The weight mg, mv square by r, the centrifugal force acting downwards. Similarly, centripetal force is also acting toward the center. So, force towards center. Centrifugal force is away from the center. This is a pseudo force. Okay. away from the center. This is the real force. And always remember, centripetal force equals centrifugal force. Okay, and centripetal force is equal to the centrifugal force, and that will act along the, it will also act how much? MVC squared by centripetal force is equals to centrifugal force, its magnitude will be equals to the centrifugal force. Okay, this is centripetal, mass into acceleration is centrifugal force. Okay, and now both of these are acting on the same direction, so we do not have the net force acting on our body. Okay, we don't have the net force acting on our body, so we experience no weight. So there is no reaction force itself. Okay, there is no reaction force, so apparent weight is zero. So this is the weight experienced by the body. Because there is no reaction force from the satellite. Just wait. Okay, student, just imagine you and a chair. You are also falling down with downward velocity, and the chair is also falling down. Why chair is falling down? Chair is falling down because you chair, it is due to centrifuge, chair is being pulled. So here chair is not being pulled, it is centripetal force that pulls down the satellite. So both are equal. When you and chair both are falling at the same time, you will not experience a downward upward reaction from the chair to you. That is why you do will not feel weight of the weight or your weight. So W is equals to R equals to zero. This is the weightlessness situation. Just remember that you will not feel any weight in a satellite due to the reaction force is zero, because the weight is equal to the centripetal force or centrifugal force in the other round. Always remember, centrifugal force is directed away from the body and it is a false force. Centripetal force is a real force. Okay. Okay. Now, okay. Just remember this formula, important formula, and done it.